Now let's break for our first 3D printing update, which we've done on the podcast before, but we've never done it on YouTube. So let's do this proper. Hit it. What is AG3D? We provide design, reverse engineering, and 3D printing services. Our goal is to bring your ideas into reality. Entrepreneurs looking to create a prototype to test their idea, college students who need to 3D print a model for a project, and anyone who wants to create something new, useful, or just fun. It's all possible with AG3D printing. Not only are we going to provide engineering services for people to bring their ideas to life, we're going to educate. We will be creating 3D printing videos. We'll share tips, tricks, troubleshooting guides, and projects for anyone who wants to 3D print for themselves at home. We want to help with the basics so that anyone can climb the steep learning curve faster and with more confidence. This week, I want to share something a little more visual. So if you're just listening, make sure to check the YouTube video later. As you may have noticed, we changed our set a little bit here. This is the AG3D logo printed in multicolored PLA from Hatchbox and Rigid Ink. Yes, this part was printed all at once using two colors. No, I am not getting paid by either company to say I use them. But I regularly use both, and for each different reasons. You know, Hatchbox balances the quality versus cost equation for me, and Rigid Ink's filament is great, but I usually save it for some special projects. Honestly, with a little calibration, any decent filament can look great and perform well, if you're willing to put the work in to get it calibrated. The logo plate was created using the Prusa i3 Mark II. The green PLA is from Hatchbox, and the purple PLA is from Rigid Ink. I printed it using 200 micron layer height, 20% rectilinear infill, and I used a thin layer of PVA, or glue stick for those that don't know, and had it cross-hatched on the bed surface to make adhesion better. Glue stick, for those that are unaware, is very useful for basic FDM 3D printing. To close out this week's 3D printing update, let's talk about how I use 3D printing to solve a problem. Engineering is solving problems, but not every solution has to be complicated. Since I can't afford to just buy some crazy contraption that will hold my camera exactly where I want it, I got creative and 3D printed some shit. The issue was that the best place to mount the camera was right above the monitor I used for the show. But the monitor was really shaky, and I'm Greek, and I can't help but fling my arms around when I speak. In order to fix the camera mounting, I created a GoPro arm setup that attached to the top of my monitor. To fix the monitor shaking, I designed and 3D printed two stabilizers that hold up the monitor from underneath and keep the camera steady through even my most wildest gestures. In the end, it cost me less than $100 based on AG3D services, and that allowed me to create the idea, test it, and find a custom solution all within a few days of work. Compare that to the various rigs and setups you can find online for cameras. It can get very pricey quickly. Just a quick search online for some camera rigs and stands, and you can look to pay $1,000 pretty effortlessly. 3D printing helped me create a completely custom, effective, and fast solution for fractions of the cost. Just another way that 3D printing can be used to solve almost any problem. This has been the 3D printing update. Don't forget to check us out on Instagram at AG3D Printing, on our website, www.ag3d-printing.com. If you're a student or teacher, get 25% off every order. Just email us with your school email so we know that you're still a student or staff member. If you're new to AG3D printing and want to start your first project, contact us and mention Today in Space. You'll get 15% off your first 3D print from now until June 30th of this year. Thank you for joining us. Don't forget to check out our Patreon page if you want to learn more about our science communication initiative and see all the rewards you can get for helping support us monthly and help us grow the show. Subscribe to the podcast on iTunes or your favorite podcast player, and to our YouTube channel as well. Please like and share if you like what we're doing. Every one of those goes a long way towards spreading love and spreading science. Have a great week. We'll talk to you soon.